Pinag-aralan natin, if I remember it right, during our meeting in Kuya Bates Hall, ang sabi nga noon, in view of God's mercy, let's offer ourselves as living sacrifice. Yeah? Diba? So, we have to change our mindset in terms of stewardship. In order for us to be able to become a good steward o mabuting katiwala, kailangan una sa lahat, baguhin natin yung ating pag-iisip. And dito natin sisimulan, change our mind. You know, this is a trust given to be entrusted with, yung stewardship. The biggest roadblock of stewardship, yung pagiging mabuting katiwala, ang pinakamalaking hadlang or biggest roadblock is the idea of self-preservation. Ano ba yung sabihin ng self-preservation? Kasi alam natin, self-preservation, yung wala tayong unang inisip kundi sarili lang natin. Diba? Hindi tayo magiging mabuti katiwala, excuse me, we're not going to be a good steward if the only thing that we are going to think about is ourselves. Excuse me. The lack of concern or there is no servant attitude. So, we need to consider stewardship as a calling. Number two, a good steward is not lazy. Sabi ganun, a good steward is not lazy. Nakita naman natin yun sa servant kanina, who among those servants have been commended by the Lord? Those who trade, those who work, di ba? Those who does not compare, di ba? Hindi, kasi maraming mga tao ngayon yung lagi, kaya sila nagiging tamad because they fall into that trap of comparison. They do not complain. They don't even criticize. Regardless of what resources given, they still push through. Kahit maliit lang yung binigay, kahit mas malaki yung binigay doon sa isa, nagtrabaho pa rin siya. Nakita niyo yung binigay ng 2 talents? Nag-complain ba siya? Sabi ba, Panginoon, bakit ganun sa kanya, 5, sa akin, 2 lang? No. We never see any comparison made. He was not lazy despite of 2 talents was given to him. Diba? He never even criticized. Diba? Walang criticism. Sabi nga, you know, sa Kristiyano, bawal ang tamad. Diba? Sabi ni Pastor Kedapis yun, diba? Ayan, bawal daw ang tamad sa Kristiyano. Kasi sabi nga yun sa katabi mo. Sabi, you know, isa sa mga bagay na nagustuhan ko nung ako'y natira sa Pilipinas, lalong-lalo na po sa Olonga po, alam nila nanay at tatay ko. Sabi nga na, may malay kalatwa doon, bawal ang tamad sa Olonga po. Pero most importantly, bawal ang tamad sa Kristiyano. Okay? So that is something that we have to learn. In order for us to be a good steward, number one, we have to treat it as a calling. Number two, we should not be lazy. Okay, number three, a good steward works, invests, and saves for tomorrow. Not only that, he or she not lazy, but at the same time, we have to work. Meaning, we have to cultivate. Look at what the 2 servants did. They trade, they work. Diba? Nagtrabaho sila. Meaning, they did not settle for what they have. Nag-double na eh. Diba? Kung ano yung binigay sa kanila, dinoble nila. Pinagtrabahuhan. Question. Yung bang, are those 2 servants knows that eventually they will get what they work for? No. Alam nila na ibabalik nila yan. But despite of that, they still manage to work for their master. Diba? Ito yung dapat na mindset natin. Kailangan magtrabaho tayo. Diba? And look at that. Ang sabi ko, work, invest, and save. Kailangan, hindi lang tayo nag-work, dapat nag-i-invest din. Dapat, we make our money works for us. Diba? What's the ang magagaling dito yung mga accountant natin. What's the difference between saving and investment? Saving is for short-term goal. Ito natutunan ko sa seminar. Investment is something that can grow for your future. Okay? So yung savings, para lang yun sa mga immediate needs.
Emergency
fund. Sino sa atin dito ang may saving? Lahat may saving. Sino sa atin dito ang may investment? Yan ang malaking problema. Sometimes we have, hindi lang dapat tayo nagsisave, we need to put some investment. Diba? And look at that. We have to work, and then we have to invest, and then once we invest, that's the only time we could save. Diba? Kasi minsan nangyayari, oh, save ko na muna to. Ayaw mag-invest. Diba? Hindi lumalago yung pera. Diba? Okay. What else? What can we learn? Practical stewardship tayo, ah. A good steward, think and work smart. Diba? Hindi lang tayo nagtatrabaho, kailangan ginagamit din natin yung mind. We have to use our mind. We have to make things, you know, we have to cultivate things, sabi nga. Diba? We have to cultivate. Maraming tao po, you know, listen to this, there are so many people, they are so hardworking. But the problem is sometimes they don't use their mind. You know, 10 taon lang na naging janitor, 20 years na, janitor pa rin. Nothing wrong with being a janitor, pero what I'm trying to say is, you know, kailangan nag-improve, nagiging productive, di ba? Yung lumalago, di ba? Kung yung negosyo mo hindi lumago dyan, mag-invest ka sa ibang negosyo. Di ba? Yun yung natutunan ko doon kay, pinakinig akong kay Pastor Ed Baptist. Sabi niya, kung hindi na lumalago dyan, isip ka rin ng iba. Kailangan ginagamit mo yung wisdom. Okay? What else? A good steward knows how to and when to give. Sabi ganun, kailangan daw marunong tayong magbigay. Okay. Going back dun sa ano, a good steward think and work smart. Meron kasabihan, di ba? There is a saying, strikes the iron when it's hot. Sabi, pag kami ang opportunity, strike it. Kasi minsan lang yan eh. But you know what? There is a better statement that I have heard. A better person strikes the iron to make it hot. Ibig sabihin, he doesn't wait for an opportunity, but he creates the opportunity. Diba? So we don't only seize the opportunity, but we create the opportunity. Dapat umaasenso. And look at this. A good steward, based dun sa nabasa natin kanina, sa servant, are they cheerful? They are. Di ba ang sabi nila? Lord, di ba sabi niya, Master, look at what I have gained. Parang they have dignity. Di ba? A good steward is positive and thankful. Ano sabi nun? They are cheerful. You know, there is a passage in the Bible that we always use that Paul also referred this for a good, ano, yung good steward. Look at this. So chapter 9 ng 1 Corinthians yata yun. Sabi niya gano'n sa verse 6, remember this, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion. For God loves a cheerful giver, and God is able to bless you abundantly so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. Sabi ganon, kailangan daw maging cheerful giver tayo. And mind you, I have heard this so many times during sa pagbibigay natin ng tithing. Right? So, ang tanong, does Paul left or say it is good enough? Sabi ba ni Paul, okay, you know, to be a cheerful giver, that's good enough? No, it's good. But is that what's the tone of his letter? No. Look at this. Sabi niya ganoon, on verse 8, I mean, on chapter 8, prior to that, chapter 9, na binasa natin, sabi niya sa verse 1, look at this. And now, brothers and sisters, we want you to know about the grace that God has given to the Macedonian church. In the midst of very severe trial, sabi niya, may trial na yung mga Macedonian, still, their overflowing joy and their extreme poverty welled up in the rich generosity. For I testify that they gave as much as they were able and even beyond their ability, entirely on their own. They urgently pleaded with us for the privilege of sharing in this service to the Lord's people, and they exceeded our expectation. They gave themselves first of all to the Lord, and then by the will of God also to us. So what is being discussed there? Yung pagbibigay daw natin. Okay, we are in the topic of a good steward should be a giver. So yung sinasabing cheerful giving, ang kinakausap niya doon, yung mga taga Corinthian church, yung mga taga, nakalimutan po kung yung lugar eh. Pero, Apostle Paul was comparing them to the Macedonian people. Doon sa Macedonian people, sabi niya, sila nga eh, puro problema na, despite of their poverty, they gave beyond expectation. So, doon sa sinasabi niya sa chapter 9, cheerful giver, kasi yan yung situation ninyo eh. Pero look at them, the Macedonians. Despite of their problems, they were able to give more. Ito yung sinasabi dito na a good steward should be positive and thankful. We should be cheerful. Okay? And lastly, sa practical application natin sa stewards, a good steward experiences reward. Okay, let's see here. A good steward experiences reward. You know, I just want to make sure that we understand this part of the process. You know, ang sabi doon, a good steward experiences reward. We have to understand that reward is at the end, not at the front. Kasi, you know, the problem with many people nowadays, they celebrate first before they start working. Kaya madalas, wala nang pera. Ubus na agad. Kasi, nag-celebrate na eh. May reward na agad yung sarili. They all started rewarding themselves even they haven't accumulated the pay yet. Diba? The reason why we are stuck in debt is because we always break that cycle. Nauuna yung reward kesa dun sa work. We have to work first before we reward. Okay? It's not wrong to reward. Kailangan yan. Kaya natutuwa ako dun sa mga nag-sponsor dito. Nag-sponsor sa Wonder Man. Nire-reward nila kayo. That's good. Right? But it should happen after our hard work. Okay? The same goes on that saying, don't count the chick while the egg is not yet broken or hatched. Kasi marami sa atin dito talaga, kisita ako. Siguro next month, pag sahod ko, bilang na agad. Hindi pa sumasahod, nabilang na. Alam na kung saan dadalhin yung pera. Naubos na, di ba? I hope we don't fall into that trap. You know, it is not bad to borrow money. Listen to me, it is not bad to borrow money. So kung kailangan nyo ng pera, borrow to Sister Lira. But there's a but. It is not bad to borrow money, but as long as you are already planning a way to pay it back. Pwede kayong mangutang. Basta importante, bago kayong mangutang, kailangan nakaplano na. You know, you already plan how are you going to pay it. Kasi marami pong nangungutang, a lot of people are borrowing, wala silang plan of how to pay it back. I have nothing against anyone who is borrowing, ha? Hindi ako nagpapatama. But what I'm trying to say is, this is how we should roll. This is how we should live. This is how we should become a good steward. Okay? Kailangan ganito tayo maging mabuting katiwala ng Panginoon. Kung hindi, mababaon tayo. And you know what? Sabi ko kanina, the biggest problem nowadays is it's rooting on money. Maraming tao wala sa church, kasabihin ko to in loud voice, maraming tao wala sa church because kailangan nila ng pera. As ang nakalulungkot, they are even working during Sundays. Okay? Again, I have nothing against working if you don't have a choice. But sometimes you have the choice, but you